So children, welcome to another lecture of mathematics. And we had already started exercise 1.3. So this chapter name is Rational and Irrational Numbers. I hope you are watching all the videos. And as you are knowing that we are having 5 to 6 days, I think so. Out of the 6 days, 5 days are having mathematics. In the curriculum, means in the current timetable. So better be prepared. Do not miss any lecture. Watch the video completely. Every part of it contains all the necessary details. So rather than asking in the WhatsApp group, please tell me about this, please tell me about that. Or better expect that you watch the video completely. Okay. So this is the first chapter. So this is session one. And for the first chapter, this is lecture number 4. Lecture 4 it is. And we had already started exercise 1.3. Okay, so we had done some questions also. Taking up the upcoming questions, next is, and see, pattern for one question is same. So those we take one question of that type only, remaining on the all can be done on the same lines. Still, if you find some doubt, you please tell me. From question number 2, I am taking one more part. Question number 2, I am taking the fifth part. Second question is the part. What it is saying? Write the decimal expansion of each of the following numbers and say what kind of decimal expansion. So basically for question number 2, you have to write the decimal expansion and also tell what kind of decimal expansion, terminating, non-terminating, recurring, or non-terminating, non-recurring. So first of all, we'll check what you have to tell the, you have to write the decimal expansion. So what the part is 3 by 13. It is 3 by 13. Second question, fifth part is 3 by 13. Let's divide it. You can use the method or that way the book has given us. In a short example only. So leave the table like this. 3 has to be divided by 13. It won't go in a single time because 3 is smaller. So write here 0 and make a point, 0 point. So here 30 will come. 13 goes up, 26. How much remains? 4 remains. Again small because of the decimal, it will come here 40. Then what next? Then 13 3 is 39. 1 comes. Again here, because the decimal it will come 10, but still it is smaller, so put a 0 here. Then what? One more 0 will come. Then 13 5 is 65. Then 13 6 is 78. Then what? 13 7 is up. So 78, 88, 89, 90, 91. 91, that will be there. So 13 8 is up, 13 7 is up. Extend it also. 7 3 is 21, 1, 2, 91. What remains? 9 comes. Again, because of decimal, become 90. And what? 13 6 is 78. 78, 88, 89, 89, 91. So 13 6 is 78. 78, 280, 12, again 120, then 39 is up, 9 is 27, 2, 9 is 2, 11, so 9 is up. So 10 minus 7 is 3. 2 is 1 and this only 3. Again it comes 30. And what? Don't you feel again same thing with Bhavalo? That means, what should it be? You write here, therefore, 3 by 13 is equal to 0.20376 and you put a bar on that. Yes or no? So how write that? It will be 0.230769. And see here, this will be what? Don't you think the same pattern will repeat? So you can put a bar on this. That will be your answer for the decimal expansion part only. Something more it has asked? Yes, what it has asked? Type of. Ideally, we can get the type of decimal expansion first. And then also point out what? Tell the decimal expansion. So first type you should take tell, but not a problem, you can take either of the parts in the same way only. Okay. And see, from your process only you know now it is what? So, but you have to mention that also. So right here, the denominator 13 cannot be expressed in form of 2 to the power m into 5 to the power n. In bracket you write m and n are whole numbers. Must mention this. Whole numbers. BERS. Therefore, 3 by 13 will have a non-terminating non-terminating but recurring. Or repeating. Decimal expansion. I hope this is clear to all. Nothing new in this one. Only thing is that you have to see which pattern is being followed here. Okay. I hope this makes clear all the questions. So second question, all the questions are on the same lines. So I hope you can do it. If any question you find specific problem, you please tell me so that I will discuss in the next class. Then what next? Third question. Third question says, without actually performing the long division. That means, see children, are we performing the long division here? Yes, we are performing. So the second part of the question says, without performing the long division. Without performing the long division. That means how you can tell without performing? Only you have to prime factorize the denominator. Okay children. So I am taking the third question, second part. You would say what is the purpose of third question? See, in the second question they are asking, okay, show the long division, show the decimal expansion. But the third part says without performing the long division. So second part is 17 by 8. 17 by 8. So right here, prime factorizing 8 will be equal to 2 to the power 3 into 5 to the power 0. So right, since the denominator can be expressed as 2 to the power 3 into 5 to the power 0, therefore 17 by 8 will have a terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal expansion. See, learn to remember and learn to write in every question also, so that it will be must be mentioned in the copies. All the questions I am solving on the board must be there in the class of copies. Additionally, you can solve the remaining also what we are not doing, because that has to be a part of your class of copies. So that will be also your homework. I will take one more part from third question. The third, second part I have done. So many parts are there, I think so in third. Let me take the sixth part. Third question, sixth part. Method remains same. What the fraction is? It is 77 upon 210. 77 upon 210. If you remember, I had told that look for P by Q in the simplest form also. Are they in the simplest form? No. They can be written as what? 7 11 is a 77 and 7 is a 21. Okay? Now you factorize. So right here, prime factorizing the denominator. So 30 will be what? You can show here. 30, 2 15s are, then 3 5s are, 5 1s are. Now see here, 2 and 3 is there, but one more is number is coming here. Yes or no? Denominator 30 is equal to 2 to the power 1 into 3 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 1. So what you write? You will write here what I am writing now. You will write 'Since the denominator contains a prime factor, bracket write 3, other than 2 and 5. So 77 by 210 will have a non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. I hope when I am writing, you will also write. Practice to write, children. Otherwise, there is no purpose solving it, because you will remember the things now and then you will forget it soon. Okay. So then these are the questions. We have done so many things regarding this. Something more we can do. I'll give you an idea of what we are going to solve next. You see, fourth question also same pattern, fifth also the same lines.
Then sixth one also on the same lines. Seventh one, decimal expansion of 1/7. So how the decimal expansion will be 1/7? Just divide, just like you have done. So seventh also the same pattern. You try it. And expect the following in the form of p/q. Now eighth question is something new. I'll give the hint for eighth, but we'll discuss it in the next class. Hint for question number eighth. See, it is what? 0.3 bar. That means you write what? Let x equal to 0.3333. Then what? Multiplying both sides by 10. So what will happen? 10x equal to 3.3333 and so on. And what will you do? This is equation 1. This is equation 2. Subtracting 2 from 1. So 9x will be what? 9x equal to 3. X equal to what? 3/9. So what will happen? 1/3. Why I am writing this? It is saying express in the form of p/q. Have I expressed in the form of p/q? Yes, I have expressed in the form of p/q. What more it is saying? p/q, then p and q are both integers. Is 1 an integer? Yes. Is 3 an integer? Yes. Is q not equal to 0? Yes. So that's what it is saying. Basically, they are saying that express it in the form of a rational number. Because rational numbers are of two types also, na? Basically real numbers. Those rational numbers which will have a terminating decimal expansion, and those rational numbers will have a non-terminating but recurring decimal expansion. So I am just connecting what I have told in the previous classes. This will be method of it. This is kind of a solution only, but I will explain in more details in the next class. And we will take up questions. See, one more thing is there that you have to keep in mind always, that whatever questions are similar on the same lines, on the same patterns, that will be skipping so that you can cover maximum type of questions. Okay. Still, if some problem is there in any question, do you are most welcome to ask those questions. Okay.